Sharif Bogere has been soaking in all Uganda has to offer after having been away from his native country for close to 12 years. Bogere vanished in the U.S. state of Chicago while on national duty during the 2017 World Boxing Championships. Instead of turning to odd jobs as most people seem to do, he stayed true to his boxing passion.
As a little kid, you know, I used to watch the Rocky movies. You know, those Rocky movies, you know, they inspired me a lot. They inspired me a lot to go to America and become a world champion, you know, from Uganda. And when I went over there, I was like, this is it.
It paid off, as in 2010, he won the unified WBO, NABO lightweight title. He never looked back since then.
So since then, I got my confidence and started you know, going all.
From Kampala, Uganda, he now makes his home in Las Vegas, Nevada. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the undefeated Sharif the Lion Bogere.
Bogere, who goes by the nickname the Lion in the Ring, is a self-made boxer of sorts. As a young boy in the slum area of Kisenyi, downtown Kampala, Bogere honed his boxing skills after numerous street fights against his peers.
We started as little kids. We used to take off our shirts and wrap them on our hands, and we started boxing each other. And from there, a friend of mine took me to KBC. It was like a block away from where I used to live.
This is one of the streets in Kisenyi where young Sharif Bogere used to walk, picking bottles for sale before he joined KBC boxing gym.
When he represented Dynamic Secondary School's boxing team at the National Schools Boxing Championship, there was no turning back.
I found some boxers around Nakasero area. I asked him, hey guys, are you guys going for the school's championship? They said, yeah. So I followed them all the way, started running from the city all the way to Lugogo, and we weighed in, and from there on.
However, Bogere's mother, who thought boxing would distract him from going to school, had her reservations.
When I was still back in amateurs, then I would just go behind the door and take off, go to Nachivubo, you know, or run all the way from Wankulukuku, come to the KBC and train, you know. But then she was like, I give up.
Bogere's first years in USA were not easy. He says his boxing talent helped him consolidate himself in the USA boxing family.
Our own people, the black people down there, you know, the way they used to see me, or they used to see people from Africa, they think they're a little bit, a level above them, you know. But until I started whipping their butts, you know, and then, you know, they started giving me respect.
After struggling to get a good boxing promotions company in Las Vegas, Bogere was fortunate to land a deal with Mayweather Promotions. He says he has earned his respect in the Mayweather gym.
World champions in the gym, they gave me respect, you know, because my time hasn't come yet. These guys who are champion right now, they used to admire me, actually, some of them, when they were coming up. But, you know, everything's the timing, so they beat, you know, step by step.
Bogere is now focused on winning a world title before he starts thinking about hanging his gloves. He believes every boxer who accepted the challenge to fight him is a hero. Bogere is delighted by the fact that he's finally able to return to Uganda after 12 years and link up with his childhood friends and family. Sam Poza, NTV Sport.